test of the Oklahoma Emergency Alert.
They're processing that in these special places. And Pete, souls who've done great evil are also oftentimes in these special bardos where they are kind of, you know, gradually awakening to love. But it takes time, and guys are managing all of their experiences in these bardos. So that was something that was really important to me to learn about, that you know, some souls just don't make a direct trip to the, to the spirit world. They have to go through a process of healing their energy that has been damaged by their last life.
You're talking about ghosts, and are they like spirits that just linger on? What happens to them?
Well, what happens is that at a certain, so they're hanging out oftentimes in the place where they died or lived. They either don't recognize fully that they've died, or they're aware that they've died, but they're afraid of what lies beyond. They're afraid of letting go of the physical plane, letting go of the familiar environments that they've lived in. Mm-hmm. So it's usually fear or very, very intense emotions like anger.
Which creates the haunting.
They get stuck there. And they're resisting that tug that would pull them into the afterlife. They're really, really struggling. And they're really not able to hear or experience love. They're deaf to that. And so again, that tug to the afterlife, that tug that would bring them to a place where all is love, is kind of not fully experienced. So these people are not stuck there forever. Eventually guides begin to support and help them make the transition. But they may actually, in Earth years, stay for quite a while. It's not the time is not the same in the afterlife as it is here. So, you know, what might seem like years here could be a few moments in the afterlife. So it's learning before they can let go of the physical and begin to experience that tug back up to the landing place and ultimately the spirit world. So it could be a real journey for these folks, but they eventually make it. No one gets stuck here. George is very clear about that. These are temporary conditions, and all of these souls eventually make it into initially to be part of in some way, deal with all these residual emotions from the past life, and then they move from there into the actual spirit world.
To the phones we go. Chucky's with us in Seattle, Washington to get us started. Hi, Chucky. Go ahead, sir.
Hey, George Torrey. I hope everything is fine with you.
Everything's good, Chuck. Thank you.
I cannot wait for the show that's coming out here. I'm excited. Hopefully, with all the people who got their vaccines and all, and, you know, come meet you. I'm pretty
You should work on it. And you make sure you introduce yourself, okay?
Yes, sir. So my question was the difference between reincarnation and afterlife. Because the 13-day prayer for Hinduism, when we have that, is basically, you know, we collecting all the karma points to donate towards the soul so they can have a better reincarnation. Since you said we can, you know, just meditate and can help tap into this. And how does it work? Since you said you was going to help us. Because my main goal is to, you know, like, get a hold of my grandparents.
All right, let's start with that, then we'll get into reincarnation, Matt, with you in a second. But how do you help Chucky find his grandparents?
So if you want to reach your grandparents and you really want to understand where they are and how they are, I guess I just, if I can just briefly describe to you how to do channeling, and then you can...
And this will work for anybody.
Hurry up already.
Anybody. Anybody. It requires no
special
powers.
Come on, KFAQ.
Virtually anyone can
relay.
So, I just would encourage you, Chucky, to find a place where you kind of feel safe and grounded, a comfortable place to be. A nice, easy chair in your house. It's something you play where you feel safe.
Okay, that always took forever, so... We're going to do 6:50 a.m.